Hey everybody, it's Sandy and welcome back to my channel dedicated to helping you advocate for your own health one topic at a time. So guys, today's video is actually a recommendation of somebody else's channel. Yeah, so I keep getting a lot of inquiries about respirators, and I've said before, for a variety of reasons, I haven't moved to using a respirator. First of all, respirator is all about the fit, it's all about the seal, and then it's all about the testing. And I've seen news articles about whole hospital systems that sent respirators back to 3M and realized that they had counterfeit N95s, and those got by buying networks, distributors, hospital. I mean, if I feel like if all these people can be fooled, I can certainly be fooled. And I don't really have what I need to be able to wholeheartedly recommend anything to people. So I have discovered the channel of Aaron Collins, and he is an engineer by background and training. And so he has all kinds of equipment that he uses, and he tests various respirators. So I think that some of you might really like the demos that he does, because you can actually see when he's testing something, and he has all kinds of high-tech equipment that'll look at, you know, particles and number of particles, particulate filtration and pressure change inside the mask, the Q factor, which has to do with reconciling the breathability with the filtration. So this is all stuff that you might really want to check out if you are very interested in respirators. He's done some work with masks as well. Now, I've noticed that he did one video that I'm going to link down below in the description box, because it really drove the point home that I've been trying to articulate about the objection I have to the recommendation that the CDC has out, where they recommend that you layer, if you're going to be wearing something like one of these plain old surgical masks, that you layer a fabric mask. And this was based on one test that they did where they compared this alone to this mask with a fabric mask, and they found that the combination was better in terms of filtration. And like I said, I don't doubt that. But if you take 10 different fabric masks and test each one of them with this, you're gonna get 10 different results, because those fabric masks aren't all the same. So it doesn't make any sense to tell people to pair these with a fabric mask. They also never looked at fabric masks that incorporate polypropylene. I think a great deal of the benefit they were getting is because they were combining the cotton with the polypropylene, which I get in, say, the DNA mask or in the Starks mask. So all these things really are questions in and of themselves, but Aaron on his channel showed a fabric mask over a surgical mask, and then he showed another fabric mask over that same surgical mask, and he got very wildly different results. So I think that he really drives the point home with his demos. So yeah, you don't really find too many people on YouTube saying, go to somebody else's channel. So I don't want you to go there and stay there. I want you to come back here. But my channel content is broader than this anyway. I just think the demos that he does are really useful. In a nutshell, I think that the testing in Aaron's demos is really helpful, and it just really drives the point home about just how variable these results can be, and especially if you take a look at his testing of respirators. So I'm hoping to collaborate with him on something. I had an idea. I sent him an email. So I'll get back to you on whether we're going to collaborate with video. But in the meantime, when it comes to respirators, I'll just say it again. I don't feel that there's anything I can really offer. I don't have anything empirical that I could point to in terms of making a recommendation. It would all be based off of feeling. And, you know, a respirator, it really has to do with the testing. So do you trust the testing that you see from somebody who's selling it? It turns out that when Aaron tested lots of different respirators, he got pretty variable results, and he does a pretty good job of giving you a cost-benefit analysis of some of these. So, you know, respirators aren't all respirators across the board, and like I said, the authenticity is a really big deal. I'm not personally moving to using a respirator for a lot of these reasons. I prefer to focus on getting an enhanced fit and using superior materials in my masks. But I don't have a quarrel with people who want to go the route of a respirator, as long as you can find something where you can do the due diligence on it and there's some trustworthy source about whether it's empirically working. And I think that Aaron's channel really does answer that concern. So, all right, let me know if you guys have checked it out. In the meantime, if you found my channel helpful, I hope that you will subscribe if you haven't already. Please share with anybody who might find my content helpful and interesting. So let me know if this was helpful, and until next time, be well. Bye-bye.